Yeah, my name is Xisco Fauli. I am from Valencia, Spain, but I live in Granada. And I am the QA engineer in the Document Foundation. Well, it was about regression finding interoperability regressions in LibreOffice. It's based on a tool created by Milos Sharem, something like that. I don't know how to pronounce it. And well, he gave a talk in a LibreOffice conference in Brno. So I've been working on this tool, and well, my talk in Fosden was about this. Basically, what we check with this tool is if we introduce interoperability regressions in the documents. So we compare it with Microsoft Office 2010, and we see if documents are displayed correctly or we have introduced regressions in the display of the document. With this tool, we check how the documents are imported into LibreOffice, but we also check how they are exported. So what we do is we open it with LibreOffice, we export it, and then the resulted document we have, we check it and we open it with Microsoft Office and see if everything is correct. It's kind of. Let's say it's 80% automated. So all the scripting and import, export, and comparing the documents is automated. But in the end, we have to check it manually if we have introduced that regression or not. The more documents we test, the better, because we have a better coverage. So right now we are working with 1,000 documents, but it has been moved to a virtual machine recently. So the idea is to, let's say, 5,000 documents or even 10,000 documents. So that would be ideal. Yeah, we take them from the backtrackers, from different backtrackers, Baxilla, well, from LibreOffice backtracker. We also take them from AbbeyWorld backtracker, KDE backtracker, so from different backtrackers we gather all these documents. Yeah. I knew about LibreOffice the day it was forked. I read it in the internet. So I got curious about the project and I joined the mailing list and so on. And the same year, I was able to participate in the Google Summer of Code. So it was in 2011. And yeah, I succeeded in this Google Summer of Code. And since then, I've been contributing to the project every now and then when I had some spare time. I did some development and I also contributed in QA. And then this year I had the opportunity to join the team as QA engineer, so yeah. It's useful to us nowadays, to the QA team, because we can more or less find how many crashes or how many users are affected by that crash. So that's kind of important information to us, so we can set the priority based on these numbers. That's one of the priorities we have nowadays, and I think it's going well, because when I joined the project, well, I didn't say it, but I joined the project in September 2016. And at that time, the numbers were around 750, and right now are around 500, or even sometimes even 450, which is, well, we got a good gain here. So we reduced it a lot, the numbers. Well, it's important that everything is as much detail as possible. Then we appreciate if there are some clear steps to follow in order to reproduce the bug. Then it's also important to have a document in order to reproduce the bug. And I think it's important that reporters try to find if the same bug was reported before. Otherwise, we are reporting the same bugs again and again. So then it's more work for us to do in order to find these duplicated bugs. So we have different communication channels. We are going to leave them here in this video, in the description. And I think that's the direct approach, just to go to this communication channels and contact us directly. Otherwise, we have some easy tasks for newcomers. And one of them is to try to confirm unconfirmed bugs. And we also have some old bugs that needs to be triaged and need to be retested. So that's another task a newcomer can do. So basically go through the list of bugs and say, okay, I'm interested in this bug. Let's see if it's fixed in the latest version or not. And there's another interesting task, which is when a bug has been fixed, just to confirm that the bug is indeed fixed. So just to verify that the bug is fixed. So it's basically you just download the latest version, the latest master version, and then you check that the bug is fixed. Then we have other interesting tasks which need a bit more of knowledge, but yeah, they are all in the wiki page, so, or they can just ask us in the channel, and that's all.